Ливан, кстати, очень умный парень и прекрасно понимает, что может потерять. Поэтому, друзья, no way.
Well, I cannot say that I am not surprised, like, at all. Alright, breaking news, or not so breaking news. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Sweden All Wrestling Television. And there has been a few updates with the potential, or not so potential, match with Levon Saganashvili and Monster Michael Todd. And Igor Masurenko just released a video explaining why this match cannot happen at this time. And he said that Michael Todd needs to go to basically Slotty and then qualify to top 8 from there. He also wrote a post on VK, the Russian variant of Facebook. He wrote a much longer post where he explains in great detail of what he meant with that video. Since the entire post was made in Russian, Artem Taranenko from Top Roll King Productions, make sure to subscribe to him, where he translated the entire post, and I'm currently looking at it right now, and I'm gonna read what they translated for us. So, spasibo, Artem. At the moment, Levon is visiting Larry Wills in Dubai. Well, let's just say he came to spar, and the news has already gone that he will pull with Michael Todd. Doesn't work like that, guys. Levon is the reigning PAL world champion, and Michael Todd is just a cool guy and nothing more. He hasn't won Slotty once in his life. And now you think he can just pull Levon? Jokes aside, there's many steps that needs to be completed, like winning Slotty, being part of top 8, and then we can see something. Levon rightfully earned his title and became the strongest arm wrestler on the planet. I understand that you guys want to see this fight, but a person like Levon also understands the meaning of what he won in a fair fight. We invited Michael to the first top 8, he refused. Now he has to re-up what he sold and enjoy his breadcrumbs from WAL. Although no, in WAL he has become a super champion, and here at Slotty I think he will take 6th or 7th place. A lot less people will argue with me if Gennady Kvikvinia and Dennis were in the competition as well. In other words, he can flex his title in the US, but it won't work here with us. Our league is a world heritage of arm wrestling. We have given a different life to the word arm wrestling. We have developed a whole system and an industry, and the one who thinks with his own personal interest, not with the whole sport, let him wait a little. It will be a turn for him. Here, Larat told me that we should have made this match happen ASAP. Wow! Just a minute! And how long did we wait for you to agree to pull with Dennis? Remember everyone, that's right, 6 years! 6 years! Devon still did not agree to an arm fight with Dennis, and when we nevertheless cut him a huge chunk of money, the whole world saw this warm-up of Dennis over a man who did not bother to prepare, and lost with a score to 6-0. Next, do I need to explain to you anything else, or can you follow the rules? Judging from that text, it really sounds pissed. And I do understand where he's coming from, since Levon is a part of the PAL, and he is the top guy there, so. And since Michael Todd is in a contract with the WAL, it is basically really impossible to have this match, since Igor and Steve are not gonna let go of their champions that easily. And since the whole top 8 thing, if I understood it all correctly, you have to basically qualify to be even a part of the top 8. To then sign a contract that you are just gonna compete in this type of tournaments at this date, at this date, at this date, etc, etc, etc. So basically, once you have written this contract, and I don't really know how long their contract is, you're basically tied and you cannot really do anything from there. I mean, we can all be pissed about this as much as anyone else, but it's just the way it is. They have signed their contracts, and they're basically tied from there. I don't know, it's just from my observation from this post that Igor Masarenko made. What do you guys think of this? Just drop them in the comment section down below and let's get this discussion rolling because of what I've been seeing throughout the social media. There certainly have been a discussion started here. Although I really wanted to see this fight for myself, since this match has been basically been talked about for many, 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 many years. Since Igor has his contract, Michael Todd has to basically qualify in Slotty, become the top three, top two in that category. And from there, he can face against Levan, or how the draw is determining who they are gonna face. I mean, it sucks, I know that, but it is what it is. And we basically cannot do anything about it, so. And if you like this video, please leave a like and subscribe, and ring the bell for notification, and share this video around, because that really helps me a lot, and I really wanted to spread this news even further, so. So have a nice day, stay safe, don't be a bee, keep being awesome, take care.